Do you know the 5 secrets for successful medical device development? Here are some manufacturing insights that product developers should know. Hi, this is Gordon Stiles, the President and CEO of Star Rapid. I've been involved in rapid prototyping and new product development for over 35 years, and I'm here to welcome you to another episode of Serious Engineering for Serious Engineers.
Serious Engineering.
Well, here we are again with another Serious Engineering video, but before we get into it, I want to talk about why I do these videos. I've always seen myself as a bit of a teacher, okay? Whether I'm teaching engineering or music or Krav Maga or whatever it is, I love teaching, I love passing on my knowledge, and I hope that you people do as well. I'm sure you do. Now, if you know teachers, lecturers, trainers, or you know a bunch of students you think can benefit from this, please, please share these videos with those people. I want to spread the, as I've said before, the serious engineering love, okay? We need more engineers. We need more serious engineers. So get the word out there. And if you're a lecturer, a teacher, whatever, please use this stuff, okay? You can chop it up and cut it up and do what you want with it. Just get the knowledge out there. Thank you. And if you would like to do a live Q&A or a recorded Q&A with me, just send us an email, contact us through YouTube or whatever, and we'll set that up and we'll have some fun asking and answering questions. Thank you all very much, and here's the next video. I'm not a real doctor, but I play one on daytime television. After performing many life-saving operations, I've learned what it takes to make medical and healthcare products that are safe, effective, easy to use, and how to keep them clean. So today, I'm going to share with you the top 5 secrets for successful medical product development. Now, just relax, take a deep breath, open wide, and say, ah. 1. Easy to clean. Medical products are exposed to all kinds of contaminants. Some are just icky, while others are truly hazardous. These include alcohol, not the good kind, sadly, acids, reagents, viruses, bacteria, and bodily fluids. Ugh. That means that if your product isn't disposable, then it has to be cleaned a lot. Therefore, devices should be designed to make this easy to do. How? If the product is a case or an enclosure, and there are seams or joints between shells, then these joints should be watertight. If that's not possible, then don't hide the seam. Keep it accessible so that a swab or a fingertip can easily wipe it down. On the same point, be wary of ribs. No, not those kind of ribs. Not those either. Yes, that kind of rib. Recesses, tight radii, pockets, and other features that are hard to reach and which can provide hiding places for bugs. Sharp internal angles should be eliminated or redesigned so that they have larger and more gradual curves. Overall, it's best to favor unified designs that present a single unbroken flat or convex face that offers the minimum opportunity for dirt to collect. These surfaces should also have a smooth texture and be non-porous so that they can be swabbed, sprayed, or wiped with cleaners. If there are internal mechanisms, these must be carefully sealed against contamination as well. 2. Easy on the hands. You'll rarely find any rough or abrasive surfaces in a clinical environment. That's because it's hard to keep them clean, and they can also be a potential source of injury. But you also don't find very slick or highly polished surfaces either, because these can slip out of your hand or cause accidents. The sweet spot is a matte or bead blasted finish, something that provides tactile feedback for the user without being either too sticky or too slippery. Another important point, tools or equipment used in stressful emergency situations, especially if they're going to be held or touched, should have large rounded contours. In other words, easy to hold or grab quickly, but without sharp angles or edges that can cut someone or snag on clothing if the user is preoccupied. 3. Easy on the eyes. Matte textures on medical products tend to diffuse and absorb reflected light, which is a surprisingly important consideration, but one that's often overlooked. Why is that? Well, because most doctors' offices or hospital rooms are saturated with blue-white fluorescent lighting that provides uniform illumination. This is necessary, of course, to help doctors or clinicians to see clearly, but strong lighting can also create glare, reflections, sharp highlights, or confusing contrasts. These can all be physically and emotionally taxing in stressful situations. Therefore, all materials used in this kind of space should be bead blasted, etched, or otherwise finished with a light absorbing surface that's gentler on the eyes. 4. Simplicity. More and more healthcare products are used in the home for diagnostic, first aid, and convalescent care. And they're being used by average folks without any special medical training. Except for yours truly, of course. To help non-professionals and to prevent possible mistakes, these products need to be as user-friendly and foolproof as possible. A good way to do this is simplify the design so that the proper function is implied by the shape of the medical product. That means the shape should imply and instruct its intended use. That way, even someone who has had no instruction would be able to pick it up and immediately know how to hold it and what it's for. The intelligent application of icons, pictograms, arrows, and other visual cues are also helpful in this regard. Another good idea is to make buttons large and single function. If there are critical features, these must be easy to spot quickly so that they can be accessed in emergency situations without thinking. For these reasons, the smart use of color is also a big help. 5. Smart colors. Color can be a powerful messenger, instantly communicating both emotion and information. For example, strong colors help to separate important or even dangerous functions, maybe red or yellow, from safe ones, green or blue. Graduations of hue, descending from darker to lighter, also help to denote a range of values, you know, like reducing volume, intensity, dosage, etc. Colors can define sections or zones on a product, which are useful guides or reminders about proper usage. And of course, color has a strong emotional connection. For example, vibrant colors add energy and stimulation, which you might find in healthcare products related to fitness or activity. In other situations, bright primary colors are fun and attractive to children, while warm colors like golds and yellows impart a feeling of calm in prenatal settings meant to inspire nurturing. Light greens and blues are associated with growth and the natural world, and these are more common in surgical and clinical settings, along with soft pastels and off-whites. Conversely, bright reds and oranges in the wrong setting would be too strong and unsettling. So there you have it, the top 5 design tips for successful medical devices. Did we miss something? If so, drop us a line in the comments below. But don't tell us about that rash. You know the one, you know, that rash. No, we don't want to know, really. Please don't. Please remember to ding the bell, like and subscribe, and don't forget, we're the people that do serious engineering for serious engineers.
Serious engineering.
Be sure to tune in next time for another episode of As the Spindle Turns.
Dr. Gordon Stiles to the ER.
Does anybody know anything about the, I think it's called pancreas?
It's pancreas.
Oh, pancreas. Jesus.